Let's see. Mel, could you help me out with this?
Yeah.
All I want you to do is say stop.
Stop.
Right there?
Yeah.
Great. And can I also get your signature?
Yeah.
Thank you. Beautiful.
Oh, I've spelled my name wrong.
B is with a B.
Great. I'll take that. And if you'd hold your hand out for me,
yeah.
I'll give you your sign card so you can place your other hand right on top, isolating your card from me.
Right.
Now I'm going to need a card too, yeah? Now, with my card here and your card there, let's try something. Maybe I can get my card to travel to your hand and yours to mine. Take a peek.
Oh my gosh.
Amazing.
My hand did not move.
Awesome.
I swear.
Yeah. Oh, wait, wait. A little souvenir for you. It has your name on it. You can put that away for now. There's more. Simon, I brought a little something for you. It's a notepad of mine from school. Now, I'm supposed to take notes in it, but I usually just doodle. Simon, if you'd hold out one of your hands and sandwich your other hand right on top, lift up to only one page, all right? Got one? Great.
Yeah.
I'm going to take that from you. Now, do me a favor and just imagine whatever image you just saw floating in the air, written on a small little slip of paper, all right?
I've got it.
Great. What I want to try to do is take that slip of paper and actually throw it into Mel's signed and selected card that you've been holding onto this entire time, correct?
Yeah.
And Simon, what image were you thinking of?
A soccer ball.
Hold it right from the top, Mel. Right from the top. I want you to tear that in half. Tear it in half, seriously. Because you're going to find in between the layers of cardstock...
Oh my gosh!
...something that you might recognize.
Wow.
Simon's soccer ball.
Look at that.
Nailed it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Pound it, yeah.
What I was hoping to do was show you all something interesting with a pack of playing cards. I'm just gonna, let's say we use this one. I've got a Sharpie in my pocket. Just sign your name right on the face of the card.
All right.
Thank you. We've got the face of the card with Chris's signature on it. But I'm gonna change the back. If you watch, it happens on the count of three. That's one, that's two.
That's come three. On.
Please take a look at it. Make sure it is exactly what it seems to be.
That's my damn card.
Now I do have a bone to pick with you, sir.
I know you do.
You did say that my routine wasn't nearly as dynamic. And the truth of the matter is I've kind of taken it to heart. And in fact, I brought a special magic wand here just for you, sir.
This is always going to happen one day.
Oh, my God.
What I want you guys to do is keep your eyes on the card, but also keep your eyes on the hammer as the card completely vanishes. But for your safety, I want you to move down to the other side of the table.
You want me to go to the other side?
Yeah, would you guys just mind just sliding down just a little
sure.
bit?
Sure.
Because this is going to be interesting.
Because
when the card vanishes, people always ask, where in the world could it be? Here on the table, if you don't mind, sir. Go ahead and examine it, open it up, and tell me, is that your signature?
This is my card! That's my signature, my crappy signature.
I take it back. I take it back. That was good. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to try and do something that's never been done before. Can all of you take out your mobile phones? And I want you to just hold them up in the air. Can you all do that for me? Judges, I'd like to stand up and have a look at the audience.
Oh my God! That's crazy.
How are you doing that?
In today's world, we're all connected through our cell phones. But what I want to show you is that we're actually all connected on a far deeper level. Simon, you'll notice that a few of the devices are still red.
Yeah.
I want you just to choose three of them to come and join me on stage.
Pick the one that's all the way in the end.
You, please. In the red. Yeah. And you. Come on.
Tara, can you bring your phone as well? Can you just unlock the phone and open the calculator? Okay, that's great. Okay, here's what I want to do. So I want you to try and guess for me, how many number one selling artists do you think Simon Cowell has had on its record label?
53.
Tara, could you just type in 53?
Yeah. All right, I'm typing them now.
Go for it. And then secondly, how many millions of records do you think Mel, when she performed the Spice Girls, sold worldwide? Just go for it, millions.
102.
Tara, can you hit multiply?
Times.
Yeah, and then 102.
102, okay.
Okay, and next up, I want you to try and guess what year Heidi began modeling.
Oh,
it's a hard one.
Sorry, I'm so bad at math. 1970. Nope, 1980.
Not when I was born.
Oh, okay, sorry. 1987?
87, okay. Tara, can you hit multiplied?
Okay.
And then just 87?
87.
Wonderful. Okay, and then here's what we're going to do. Hit the plus sign.
Plus.
Fantastic. Now, a little buddy told me, Harry, that you've had a lot of girlfriends. But instead of just guessing, Tyra, what I want you to do is I want you to have your thumbs over the numbers.
Thumbs over numbers.
Now, I want you to make a random guess. I want you to close your eyes and just hit maybe like 7 or 8 numbers. Go
One,
for it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Okay, cool. Hit equals.
Equals.
Okay, sweet. Now, I just want you to read that number out for me. Is that okay?
Okay, ready?
Go for it.
73 million.
Okay, 73 million.
928,000.
928,000.
547.
547. Wonderful, guys. Give a round of applause for these three volunteers. Thank you. And for Tara Banks, please take a seat. Thank you.
It's not over yet, is it?
Take a seat, guys. Thank you very much. Okay, guys, so we've got this random number here, but
there's something bigger going on. There's something impossible. There's something magical.
I want you guys to see this.
I'm here on Hollywood Boulevard. It's a few hours until my audition. This number, 73,928,547. Does this mean anything to you?
Thank you.
What?
But wait. Do you remember at the start, I said that we're all connected on a far, far deeper level?
Yeah.
Well, Simon, I think you'll find that you've actually had 47 number one selling artists. And Mel, you sold 85 million records with the Spice
Yes.
Girls. Heidi, you started your career in 1992 when you
That's
won Models
right.
92. And Howie, you and I both know that you've not had 73 girlfriends. But that's because you married your high school sweetheart. And you've been married to her for 37 years.
Wow.
That's amazing.
Amazing.
May I come and join you at your table? Would that be okay? I'd like to share with you a trick. It uses a £50 note, one of the largest currency notes available in this country. With my sleeves rolled up, guys, with nothing in my hands, we can get a shot of this on the screen. I'm going to change this £50 note into the much rarer, infinitely more valuable Bank of Britain's Got Talent £50 note.
No way.
Now you can see we've got our head of state, Mr. Simon Cowell. We've got our beautiful princesses, of course, our queen. Son, for you to keep. Don't spend it all at once. Guys, I don't want you to feel left out. So I brought along some more cash for you, but I know deep down, you don't really want one of these. You'd much rather have one of those Bank of Britain's Got Talent. One for each of you to keep.
Oh, I love that.
Thank you very much.
What? Thought I'd finish with a trick using a picture that I've drawn. It's a self-portrait. That's me. This is where we are. Britain's Got Talent. You see, most magicians at this point would ask one of you to reach in and take a card. I'm not going to do that. Instead, if I may, I'm just going to ask each of you one question. David, if I may start with you. If I could ask you to choose a colour, red or black, whatever you say is what we will use. What colour would you like?
Black.
Black. Alicia, the black cards are split into two suits. We have the spades, we have the clubs. Again, if I could ask you to choose, whatever you want is what we will use.
Clubs.
Clubs. Fantastic. Amanda, I need you to choose a value for me. What would you like?
Nine.
The nine of clubs. Simon, you're the boss. I'm going to give you the chance, if you like, to stick with the nine of clubs, or you can overrule all of the other judges and you can choose any other card that you like. What would you like?
Seven of hearts.
The seven of hearts. Okay. Guys, there is no way I could know that you would choose the Nine of Clubs. There's no way I would know if you would overall, and if you would, what you would change to. You'll agree I haven't touched these. What I didn't tell you is that I've also drawn on the back of every single other card in this deck. Do you remember those cartoon flip books where you flick through and the little man comes to life? Check this out. You see our magician. He takes off his hat. He reaches inside. He pulls out just one card, ladies and gentlemen. Not just any card, it's the Seven of Hearts.
We are mind readers. In fact, Andrew and I are so in tune with each other, even though we went shopping separately for today's audition, we both ended up buying the same camouflage t-shirts. Let's show you what we do. Amanda, I take it you have your phone on you.
Yes, I do, actually.
If you stand here for me. Amanda, I'd like you to scroll through your contact list and stop on somebody at random.
Okay.
Look at this person's last three digits of their phone number.
Yeah.
Once you've got that in your mind, lock the phone and put your phone on the desk. Just say this person's name over and over again in your mind. I really hope we get this. And even though you picked this person, you had a free choice. Is that right? Andrew?
Amanda, in a loud, clear voice, what are the three numbers you're thinking of?
415.
415? That's exactly what I've got. Thank you. Of course, Amanda, this is a contact in your phone. In a loud, clear voice, whose number is this?
My sister, Debbie.
Debbie? That's what I've got.
Amanda, thank you so much. Please take a seat. Thank you.
How would you do that?
Simon, please join us on stage. And I'm sure everyone here will give you a really big hand. Simon! Yay! Good luck, Simon! Love you, Simon!
Go this side of the stage for us. Thank you.
Simon, would you hold that, please? We're going to go on an imaginary journey in your mind.
Oh, don't.
Oh, God, don't go there. Don't go there.
Oh, dear.
I'd like you to imagine that you're standing outside a house. You look at the door and you see a number on the door. Any number you like, Simon, please write it down. Just try to say that number over and over again in your mind. You now go into this imaginary house and you go into a living room. You look at the wall of the living room and you see a colour painted on the walls. Please write it down. Just imagine that colour all around us now. You're focused on it, right? And even though you picked that colour, you could have had anyone. You now go into the kitchen. You look over at the wall and you see a celebrity calendar. It could be anyone you like, Simon. Now, although you picked this person, that was a free choice. You know that, right? You know that. And even though you picked this person, you had a choice of thousands. Andrew?
I am getting something. Simon was asked to imagine he was standing in front of a house. He imagined a door, he imagined a number. Simon, you then walked into the house, you looked at a room that was in a single colour. Then you're asked to think of a celebrity, anyone in the world. Simon, I believe you're thinking 717, you're thinking of the colour turquoise. You're thinking of Sir Roger Moore?
May I? Ladies and gentlemen, exactly the number 717. He thought of turquoise. Ooh. You chose Roger Moore. Simon, thank you so much.
How did they do that?
Thank you so much.
So much.
Many of you may be wondering how we read minds. What you should be wondering is how we started off this performance wearing camouflage t-shirts and ended up wearing black. We are DNA. How you like me now?
Thank you.
Thanks, man.
For those that don't know, John is an Eagle. He's on the Philadelphia Eagles. He's the long snapper.
There we go.
Then you found your way into this magic, even more importantly.
And that's the other magician.
Really?
Yeah.
Who are you here with today?
My beautiful girlfriend, where? Annalise. And my mom, who's my aunt, who is the greatest mom in the entire world that started raising me when I was 12, 13 years old. My sister and I went into temporary foster care. And my mom's sister, who's sitting right there, gave up her entire life, did everything she could to fight for custody for my sister and I.
So I'm gonna give you the stage. Best of luck.
So you said you gotta make the show bigger, so boom. Anyways, okay. So I love this. Neil, you're gonna love this. We got a deck. They're all huge. Right. You guys can't miss these. All I want you to do is just touch anyone you want. It doesn't matter.
Anyone?
Anyone.
Okay.
Do you want to keep this or change your mind?
I want to change my mind.
You're that guy. Okay, here. Just touch one.
Let's go here.
Okay, stop. Do you want to keep this one or do you want to change
your mind? I'm going to keep this one.
You sure?
Yes.
I don't want to see it. I'm going to blindfold myself. Show the camera. Show the crowd.
Don't look.
I'm not looking. I'm going to look down here. Okay. Hey, everybody think of this card. Think of the color, the shape, the size, everything about it. And here's all I'm going to do is I'm going to draw this card. Ladies and gentlemen, this is ESP at its best. So far, so good. All right, here we go. So when I get this right, this is so sick. Ladies and gentlemen, the card that everybody here is thinking of. Neo, the card you're thinking of, you're feeling it right now, is none other than the Ace of Clubs. Killing it.
Uh-oh.
That's
happened.
No.
Okay, hold on. That's amateur hour. You guys thought I drew the Ace of Clubs. No way. I thought I'd step this up. And ladies and gentlemen, right here before you, I drew an entire deck of cards, and Neo's card is inside. See that? See what I mean? See what I did there? Get it?
No.
I tell you what, this would be a good trick. What was it?
You want me to tell you?
It's going to help me out a lot right now, yeah.
Five of clubs.
Let me see it. Okay, good. What if I could change that? Watch. Watch the ace. Five of clubs. I got the suit right. So I just got to add a few clubs. Watch the ace. That would have been good, though, if I could change
it.
That would have been good. Honestly,
that
would've I probably would have
walked out of the room and just quit, because I couldn't top that. Remember earlier I said it was inside?
Yeah.
Watch.
No.
There you go, Neo. And now look, I didn't want to do this, but look, just to show you, that five has been drawn on there the entire time. Oh. There is your ace. There is your five. I'm John Norenbosch. Peace out.
Does that make you a little bit nervous?
Yeah.
My man.
That was good.
Can I do something? For you. How's it feel?
I'm speechless, man. I'm speechless. You're the man.
Am I allowed to go closer to you guys?
You can, yes.
All right, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Now, the thing about bar magic as opposed to regular magic is the fact that I don't use big props. I can't afford them. And that's all I have to dazzle the world.
Right.
Now, the thing about magic that happens close to your face is that it has to be performed exquisitely. If I can pronounce that word correctly, but...
Oh.
Excuse me.
Just caught the card.
But honestly, I...
Whoa.
Just do not like card tricks because...
That's amazing.
But...
Where are you coming from?
But I have a beautiful 6-year-old son. And I want to do something to you, Miss Mel B.
Oh, wow.
That my little boy likes. Can I see your hand? The other side. Thank you. Oh, perfect. I'm going to take this ball, put it right about here. I want you to hold that ball real tight for me. Thank you. With that ball there and that ball there, we're going to go abracadabra. Open up your hand.
Shut up! Shut up!
Let me mentally assault you two on the other hands. Because I am ghetto.
Whoa. Wow. He's good. Oh, he's good.
That's good.
Whoa!
Pretty cool.
Thank you. Not my name, though.
That is the name. Whoa!
Wowza.
Tonight, I have a gift once again, which I'm going to leave in front of you, Simon, for now. I need you to just keep an eye on it and make sure no one touches it just for now. I also have the wonderful Amanda Holden's autobiography and a photograph of our judges. Alicia, I need you to do me a favour. In just a moment, I'm going to riffle through the pages. I just need you just to say stop wherever you like for me.
Okay. Stop.
Are you happy there? It's up to you.
Yep.
We can go forward.
No,
and make...
that's fine.
You happy? What I need you to do is just remember for me just the page number that you've stopped on, and
okay.
Also just the first word on the page for me.
Okay.
Have you got that? Please
yes.
Remember it, and we're going to come back to that.
Got it.
In just a moment. Now, Amanda, I actually kept the receipt for your book.
Good.
Don't panic. I was never planning on taking it back. I just wanted to show you that magic is all around us all the time. We just have to choose to find it. If I was to go back in time, for example, and get my cash back, it would look something like this. Alicia, please tell us, what was the page number that you just chose a moment ago?
176.
176.
Yes.
Inside this gift, which has been here the entire time, is in fact a message in a bottle. If you look closely, you'll see that actually it is a page. If I open it up so you can all see.
Oh.
It is, in fact, a page from your book, Amanda. Alicia, please tell us, what page have I got here?
176.
176, the same page. Please turn to page 176 as quick as you can for me, Alicia. As quick as you can, and you will find that page 176 no longer exists in the book.
Now that...
Because this isn't just a matching page, but this is, in fact,
no,
the exact page.
Oh, my goodness.
Now, Alicia, you also chose a word.
Yes.
For the first time, please tell us, which word did you choose?
One of my favourites, bottom.
Bottom.
That would be my
great choice. Great choice. Ladies and gents, it's been an absolute pleasure and a real dream come true to perform live in front of the nation tonight. Just to finish, burnt into the page, the chosen word,
oh,
bottom.
No.
Thank you.